If we look forward, we look into the future, not try to look into a crystal ball, but I think having now a more diversified product offering does make us more resilient. And by, for example, we as a group are still quite heavily exposed to the coating sector, probably still about 50% of our group. Now the coating sector currently is not in good shape. It's going through some restructuring, companies going under, companies merging. It's an industry that hasn't grown hugely in the last 3 years. It's also an industry that I don't expect will grow big in the years to come. But having bought more businesses outside that industry, i.e. into sectors like the agri sector, the formula sectors, manufacturing, non-manufacturing, automotive, mining, a little bit in construction, and the likes, has, in my view, made our business a bit more resilient than it was maybe three or four or five years ago. Looking forward, if you look per sector, the pigments division, I think, is still in for some tough times. We do have a good spread of products in our mix, but it's still very much dominated by the coatings industry for that business, and I would expect that that to be still a tough environment to trade in. We do see a bit of trickling back of Europe, which I think is good for us, and also we are opening up other export markets for that business. I must add that a part of that business growing very fast are exports into Africa, and we are definitely putting a lot of effort into that because I see where South Africa will or may have single-digit growths, the rest of Africa definitely is going into double-digit growths in various countries, and that's where we put a lot of focus in. If we look at the industrial products division, it's a business that's been growing very fast. I foresee that to happen still for the foreseeable future. There's still some products we can add to the basket. We got a very good, a very slick distribution model. We got now a countrywide distribution setup. And there also, our growth to Africa has been, although from a small base, been very fast. So I would expect that business to continue to grow on at least double-digit numbers going forward. In the next few years. If we then look at our new acquisition, the agriculture chemicals industry, as I've mentioned before, we in crop protection, which means pesticides, adjuvants, and foliar feeds type of products. Yeah, I don't have to tell you about food security. It's a sector, that's why we entered the sector. It's a very fast-growing company. It's a company that's small compared to peers in South Africa. But again, the focus is not just on the African market, but it's also on growing our African business. But we don't buy companies to keep them quiet and stable, we buy companies to grow them fast, hopefully. So I have a lot of expectation from our agri sector. Silica, as I mentioned before, is fairly stable. It will probably grow year on year, but I don't think we'll see it ever become the larger part of the group. It will probably always be in 5, 6, 7%. Part of our group. As the MD of the company, I'll be disappointed if we don't have double-digit growths, i.e. single-digit growth. Our aim has always been to have good double-digit growth, and yeah, that's the expectation I think out there, and that's the expectation we put on ourselves.